I've found a crucial witness who has finally shed light on a brutal killing. He's seen a second body with the same bruising injuries that I'm investigating. But this body also had bite marks, which he says identifies the culprit.
Do you know what animal may have done this?
Yes. Sucuri. Anaconda.
Anacondas killing humans is unprecedented. There have never been any confirmed cases. If these human deaths really are the work of anacondas, that's a huge revelation. But the extensive bruising and broken bones that I've heard about are entirely consistent with the anaconda's MO for killing prey, squeezing the life out of it. The anaconda is a water-dwelling monster with which I've had little experience. But is this animal also the cause of the disappearances around here? I need to have a close look at this highly secretive predator. Zakel then tells me his theory about how Nilton was ambushed.
Na cabeça mesmo.
Ela pegou assim.
He thinks that it probably grabbed him straight away in the head. And literally, one moment he's there in the boat. The next minute something grabs him and he's in the water. So he was literally plucked out.
The position of the bite marks reveals something else truly terrifying. From the puncture wounds on Nilton's neck, the anaconda appears to have worked its mouth around his entire head. What Sakel says rings true. Snakes are well known for consuming their prey head first. They're easier to swallow that way. This new evidence opens up the very real possibility that big anacondas can crush people to death and then swallow them whole. And I'm beginning to think that this might explain why people have vanished from around Porto de Morges. Because when an anaconda feeds, it leaves virtually no trace of its victim. Its stomach acid is so strong that it dissolves even bone.